Hi.
Oh no, I want to make sure it's recording.
Yeah, we're good. All right, let's flow, friends. Let's start in child's pose, just a nice centering place. Go ahead and close your eyes, bow down. Start to feel the earth beneath you. Let the earth's reliable, resourceful energy come up and fill you. Let the energy rise up and fill your body in a nourishing way. Every nook and cranny of your body highlighted by the blessing of knowing that you are here. Feel your breath as it flows in and out through your nose. And imagine your breath as a massage therapist, as a hug. Let that breath come up to your shoulders, knee into the shoulders, and let it relax. Let that breath wash down the length of the spine, wrapping around your hips, knee and massage into your lower back, your glutes. It's a very frisky massage therapist. Take another moment here to just allow your belly to drop. Let it hang. You've been wearing a mask today of any kind for work, for your children. Take your mask off. Let yourself be free of facade. Allow yourself to feel raw and exposed. Give yourself a little while longer than usual here. Feel the earth, to feel your breath, to feel your presence, your perfect presence at this perfect space and time. Anything other than that is a story. Relax. And know that as we flow together for the next hour, my words are just suggestions. So listen to your own inner guidance, that compass inside of you that tells you to turn it up, turn it down, or change directions. Good. When you're ready, go ahead and rise up to hands and knees, all four position. Start to rock your hips a little, right and left. Take your time to move organically. Draw some circles with the pelvis, roll through that low back. Let's spend the first few minutes to just minimize anything that's not pertinent to this moment. Place it on a shelf, let it fade away. Now everything that's present in the here and now, your awareness, your sensation, your beingness, will allow that to become more vivid, more obvious. Really tune in. If you're drawing circles, go the other way now. Keep rolling through it. You can make it your own, smaller, bigger, no one's looking. Unless you're in the living room and there's a bunch of people sitting on the couch watching you, then someone's looking. Good. When you're ready, hands and knees, neutral spine. Dip your tummy, arch your back, look up, inhale. Round your back, hollow out your belly, exhale. Zoom into your breath, dip your tummy, arch your back, get big inspiration. Round your back, exhale. Move just like that, your own cadence. Can you relax your jaw and the cheeks on your face? Relax the muscles between your eyebrows as you move now. A few more cycles. Keep pulling your awareness into what you're doing right now. Good. When your spine feels warm, tuck your toes, lift your hips, down dog, and sway those hips side to side. Keep pressing your hands really firmly. Push the mat away. Bring some weight into your legs. Explore your down dog. It's like you just came home at the end of a long day. You're in your space. You get to decompress in the way you want to decompress. Your body is your home. Move in it in a way that feels comfortable, that feels pleasing. You might explore pedaling your heels, bending one knee and then the other. When you're ready to embrace stillness, go right ahead. Be vigilant with your breath here. Take each 5 breaths as though each one was the most important breath of your whole life so far. Keep breathing 3 more. Feel the strength of your arms. Feel the connection to the ground. Good. When your 5 breaths are complete, walk to the back of your mat. Take a forward fold. Grab opposite elbows. Just drop down. You might sway a little, side to side. Feel all 10 toes spread wide. Glue your toe pads down. Your heels feel feathery, really light. Someone wrote you a message on a little post-it note, a little secret. They can slip it under your heels. What would the message say? It's a cute question. Ask yourself. Good. When you're ready, liberate your hands, travel it out, downward facing dog. Lift your heels nice and tall, bend your knees, come into crouching tiger. Press your chest into your thighs as you scoop that tailbone up mighty tall. Imagine you could rest your nipples on your knees, connecting ribs to femurs. Breathe. Shift forward to float your table, shoulders over wrists, knees right under hips, shins floating over the ground. Feel your core. Good. Pull it back to down dog. Exhale. Walk your hands back to your feet, standing forward fold. Fingertips under shoulders, inhale long spine. Exhale, deep fold. Inhale, long spine. Exhale, deep fold. Walk it out, downward facing dog. Connect. Lift your heels, bend your knees, crouching tiger, really decompress. Feel the neck is long. Shift forward, float your table, shins hover right over the mat. You're super close to the mat. Like if you forgot to shave, your leg hair would be touching. It's a pretty image, huh? Good, down dog, take it back. Nice job, big toes together behind you. Send that right leg up. Let the right knee bend, work your hip open. And draw little circles with your ankle. Re-extend that right leg nice and tall. Inhale. Your exhale, right foot outside of your left foot. So you're crisscrossing at the back of your mat. Bend your left knee to the left and drive that right heel down. Forehead towards the mat. Good. Re-extend your right leg nice and tall. Inhale. Exhale, right foot lands between the hands, low runner's lunge. Left knee down, top of the left foot down, hands to heart, Anjuleyasana. Sink heavy in your left hip. Breathe here, enjoy. Inhale. Your exhale, fingers find the mat, touch your left toes, straighten your right leg. Hands crawl forward, pull that right hip back, inhale. Exhale, pour over your right leg. Keep winging your toes towards your forehead. Inhale. Exhale, shift forward, runner's lunge. Plant your hands in that right leg tall. Keep your right leg lifted as you shift forward, shoulders over hips. Be really careful bringing your left knee down, the top of the left foot down. Send your left arm forward, spinal balance. Keep your eyes steady, breathe. Stay here, bend your right knee, left hand finds the top of the foot. Lift your thigh, try to square your shoulders. Easeful in your eyes. Looking inward rather than out. Good. Try not to flinch as you release. Opposite arm is leg. Bring your left hand down. Bring your left shin to the left. Heel right hip and right chest open. You can look down to your left thumb for comfort. Good. When you're ready, bend your right knee. Right hand will go up the top of the foot. Flip your angel wings together, press your chest through. Breathe. Feel your heart open. Good. Open up, same arm as leg. Inhale. Look down at your left hand. Sweep your right foot outside your left hand. Spin your left shin off the mat to the left. Right hand inside arch of right foot, left arm high. It's going to feel like extended set angle pose. Use your right shoulder into your right thigh to pry it open. Reach, large inhale. Exhale, gaze down, left hand down. Spin your left shin, tuck your left toes, runner's lunge, right leg lifts. Bend the knee, open up the hip and draw some hip circles. Good. Re-extend that right leg nice and tall. Inhale. Exhale, right foot steps between the hands. Straighten both legs as you walk to the left. Toes angle in, heels out, hands under shoulders. Inhale. Exhale, fold, prasarita. You could go upside down if you want to, or you could start to walk your hands out more like a down dog. melt in the heart. You have 5 breaths. Your feet are on the earth, stay light in your heels, and think of hugging your knees to your quads. Good, another inhale. Your exhale, feet come down or hands walk back in depending on what you are doing. Walk forward, runner's lunge, and step back to down dog. Reach those hips up tall, melt your sternum down. Take 3 loving breaths, in and out. Over and over again, if your mind wanders away to something that's not pertinent to the moment, bring it back. Here we are. Good. When you're ready, roll forward to plank pose. You're going to hold this first one. Charge energy forward through your crown. Push energy back in your heels. Feel the gap between your shoulder blades spread out. Maybe close your eyes or imagine you're looking at a sunrise coming over the horizon of water. Purple, golden light bouncing off the water. Create something beautiful in your mind. Good, another inhale. Exhale, lower all the way down and curl your toes, inhale. Exhale, roll the shoulders, lift your heart, breathe right here, close your eyes. You can continue to visualize and watch that gorgeous sunrise. Birds flying overhead, a gentle breeze, add the elements you like. Another inhale. Exhale, down dog. Deep breath in. Let go. Leg big toes together. Left leg lifts. Left knee bends. Work your hip open. Breathe into that left hip. Press passionately down through your right hand so you don't collapse into that right shoulder. Re-extend the left leg, in breath. Out breath, left toes outside of right toes. So you're crisscrossing your thighs. Bend your right knee to the right as you drive the left heel down. Imagine that your forehead could touch the ground. Breathe into this kind of leaning dog. Always imagine if a down dog went to a cocktail party, it would just kind of lean up against a counter like this. Spit and fly, pick up lines.
Just kidding. Clearly, I don't go to a lot of cocktail parties. That's what I think people do.
When you're ready, lift the left leg nice and tall, big in breath. Out breath, left foot lands between your hands. Right knee down, top of the right foot down, Anjali Asana, hands to heart. Maybe rest your eyes closed. If your shoulders are melting forward, roll those shoulder blades back and down. Another inhale. Exhale, fingers down, Ardha Hanuman, as you straighten your left leg. Right knee over right ankle, walk your hands out, in breath, surrender. Practice just releasing the muscles, releasing effort, releasing control. Just be here. Keep winging your left toes towards your forehead. Another inhale. Exhale, shift forward. Runner's lunge. Plant your hands, left leg lifts. Keep that left leg lifted as you shift forward until your shoulder heads are over your longest fingers. Be very delicate with your right knee as it comes down, top of the right foot down. Left hand under left shoulder, right arm forward, spinal balance. charge energy through your phalanges, back through the heel. Everything is aware. Stay here, bend your left knee. Right hand grabs the top of the foot. Lift that left thigh bone, Marjorie Asana, your tiger. Not like the one on Netflix, not that tiger guy, different. Good, when you're ready, opposite arm is leg, inhale. Exhale, right hand under right shoulder, spin your right shin to the right. Peel your left hip and left chest open, it kind of feels like half moon. Can stay here, bend your left knee, left hand grabs a little edge of foot. Angel wings clip together, chest moves forward. Good, try not to fling, just slowly release, inhale. Your exhale, you're looking down, leap your left foot outside your right thumb. Spin your right foot off the mat to the left. Left hand inside of left foot, right arm high, open it up like side angle. So that left thigh is externally rotating. One more inhale. Exhale, right hand comes down, runner's lunge. Straighten both legs, walk to your right for Prasarita. You can go upside down or grab your two big toes. Inhale, pull up on them. Exhale, elbows wide, crown of the head towards the mat. You might floss your hips right and left a little. Get into your creases. Breathe. If you're upside down, you have 5 breaths to explore that inversion. If you're upside down, think about how you want to land. Try that gracefully. Keep using your core to control the momentum of the leg. You're ready. We release the toes. We all meet forward in a runner's lunge. Plant your hands and take that left leg tall. Let the knee bend and the hip open. Just draw some nice big hip circles. It's a very multicultural playlist. We have like Japanese, some African beats, we have some country. Not kidding you, it's a small world is coming. When you're ready, left leg lifts, big inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog, breathe here. Notice if your mind wandered away at all, use the next 3 breaths to reel it here. Notice how nice this moment is, this breath. Good. When you're ready, lift your heels, bend your knees, step to the top of your mat. Feet hip width, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, forward fold. Stay low, set up for crow, plant your hands. Bring your big toes together, knees wide, press your knees into your upper arms. If this is new to you, just keep your feet down, maybe just pick up one foot and the other. If you're proficient in this, you might cross the ankles and send one leg back at the Padmasana. You have a few more breaths. For whatever you chose to do, we're meeting in a forward fold. Toes behind the wrist, inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Stay low, fish hook your big toes, pull up on them, inhale. Exhale, elbows wide, fold in. Drop your head, relax your neck. You might do little swimmies with your shoulders, roll them out. Good. Find stillness, drop in, give it another inhale. Exhale, fingers down, bend your knees, roll up for 3. Take your time, the amigos, 2. 1, come to stand, massage your shoulders. And find an interlace at your lower back, knuckles down, chest up, inhale. Exhale, hinge and fold. Chin tucks into chest. Arms top wall. Breathe. Inhale here. Exhale, hands find the mat. Step back to high plank. Top of a push-up. Pull your right knee into your right tricep. Sweep it across to your left tricep. Return to your right. Down to your right wrist. Up to your right tricep. Sweep it to the left. Down to the left wrist. Up to the left tricep. Sweep it back to the right. Float your right leg back just an inch over the ground. Charge through your heels. Give it one more inhale. Good. Exhale, right foot down. Find symmetrical high plank. Inhale. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Heart pulls up. Thighs up. Exhale, down dog. Breathe as you are. Enjoy yourself. 5 breaths. If you want to take a handstand or forearm balance, you could do that. If you want to take a child's pose, you can do that. You have 3 more breaths. If you're doing something other than down dog, come to meet us. Bring your big toes together behind you. Lift your heels and try to tiptoe walk your toes towards your wrist. Toes are together. We're coming into crow as you bend your elbows. Bring your knees behind your arm bones. Tip forward. Maybe one or both feet up. If you want to try to fly one leg back, you can. That's where you transfer the weight into one tricep. The other leg will float off its tricep and push back. For whatever you chose to do, we meet in a forward fold. So toes behind wrists. This time, slip your hands under your feet. You might want to bend your knees. Move any rings out of the way. Toes come to rest. Inhale, level. Exhale, fold. Relax now. Breathe. You can wiggle your toes a little on your wrists. It's an unusual sensation, so it feels kind of neat. Relax that when you're ready. Liberate your hands. Put a little bend in your knees and roll up for 3. Take care. 2. 1. Come to stand. Roll your shoulders. Good. Hands to your lower back. Find the interlace. Knuckles down. Heart up. Inhale. Exhale. Lead with your heart. Hinge from your hip hollows. Carry your arms over. Tuck your chin. Relax. Skin on the neck, soft. I don't know what that accent was. One more inhale. Exhale, hands come down. Step back to high plank. Find symmetry to begin. You need that strong base for this. And then float your left foot up. Left knee, left tricep. Left knee, right tricep. Left knee, left tricep. Left wrist. Left tricep, right wrist, right tricep, left tricep, float it back an inch over the ground. You've got this. Energy forward in your crown. Good. Left foot down, reorganize, standard high plank. Inhale, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, lift heart. Exhale, lift tail, down dog. Breathe with me, 5 breaths. Child's pose or an inversion if you want that. When you're ready, remain in down dog. Lift your heels, bend your knees, step forward, top of the mat. Big toes touch. Inhale, level your spine. Exhale, deepen your fold. Chair pose, bend your knees, hips low, arms high. Inhale. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, lift chest. Exhale, twist. Left elbow outside, right knee or thigh. You might open your arms, left arm down, right arm high. Stay here, come to side plank. Hands come down. Squeeze your ankles and knees together as you lift your feet. If it's easy, you can pike your heels forward or straddle or split your legs rather, like scissor. For whatever you chose to do, we come back to knee and revolve chair. Left arm down, right arm high. Inhale. Exhale, standing forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, step jumper float. Look through your vinyasa. We meet in down dog together. Big toes together behind you. Send that right leg up. Lift the right knee bend. Let the hip open. Breathe into that generous bend. The openness of your right hip. Stay here and flip your dog. Ball the right foot hands wide at the side. Roll your heart to the heavens. Lie back. Let your right fingertips play over the ground. Breathe. In the spirit of lightness. Another inhale. Exhale, right hand under right shoulder, right leg lifts tall. Inhale. Exhale, right knee, left shoulder, slide your right leg through. Spin right hand right, left heel forward, fall in triangle, open your heart. Turn the whole front line of your body towards the heavens, receive. Another inhale. Exhale, left hand under left shoulder, thumbs face each other, right leg lifts. Inhale. Exhale, bring your right knee towards your right elbow. We're gonna make a box. Left elbow, left wrist. Right wrist, right wrist. One more. Right elbow, left wrist. Send it tall. Big inhale. Exhale, right foot steps through. Cross Arita. Straighten both legs. Walk to the left. Right fingertips forward of your pretty or handsome face. Thread your left arm through. Grab your right shin and twist. Close your eyes if you wish. Enjoy. Good. Inhale. Your exhale, unwind. Keep your legs. Just walk towards your right leg. Wrap your hands around your shinning calf and bow your nose towards your knee. Hug into that right leg. Another inhale. Your exhale, crawl forward, runner's lunge. Step your left foot forward. Return to chair, hips low, arms high. If anyone knows Taylor Swift, if you can just send her this video and tell her I put her on every playlist, and that would almost be 100% true. One more inhale. Exhale, brush your fingers back, crown of the head forward. Lift your heels, down in your knees, plant your hands, crow. Please don't anticipate what's coming next because it might be different from what you're thinking. Half moon, right toes behind right wrist. Heel, left hip, and left chest open. Spread like fingers and toes. Feel like you're sandwiched between two supportive walls. Stay or bend your left knee. Left hand grabs a little toe side of foot. Angel wings clip together. Keep breathing. Adho Chandrasana, big inspiration. Exhale, left hand down.
Oops, sorry, I turned my light off of my foot. Let me see if I can turn it back on. Oh, there we go. I'm still stuck. Okay, ignore me. Left arm down, square your hips, right arm high.
Ground into your right heel so you don't drop into your right hip. Keep rolling your chest open. Option to stay or standing half bow. Bend your left knee. Right hand grabs the top of the foot. Inhale. Exhale, kick the foot into the hand. We did all of this in our warm-up. The knee was down then. Good. Open it back up. Habarita Ardha Chandrasana. Inhale. Exhale is needle. Hands down, left leg tall. Fold in. If you want to go upside down here, you can. Planting your hands, doing your L hops. If you want to focus more on balance, you could wrap your hands around your right ankle. Lift the left leg. For whatever you chose, give it one more inhale. Exhale, runner's lunge. Downward facing dog to get back. Crouching tiger as you lift your heels, bend your knees, press your chest into your thighs. Breathe. Good. High plank, top of a push-up. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, scoop the chest through. Exhale, down dog, lift your hips. Deep breath in. Let go. Big toes together behind you. Reach that right leg up. Inhale. Exhale, right foot stands between your hands. Virabhadrasana one. Take your time. You can square your shoulders. Keep your legs super strong. Inhale. Exhale, Virabhadrasana 2. Your wrists float over your ankles. Peaceful warrior, left hand down, right arm up and over. Inhale. Exhale, side angle. We did a variation of this in our warm up. Feel that long line of energy. We're here, 8 breaths. You could stay or bind. If you're bound, you could come to bird as you step your left foot forward. Transfer your weight onto your left foot, especially the big toe, root to rise. Once you stand, start to straighten your right leg if you want. Breathe as you are. If you came up, retrograde out of it. Knee back and side angle. We're all together in side angle. Inhale. Exhale, peaceful warrior. Inhale. Exhale, straighten your right leg, reach. Inhale. Exhale, Trikonasana. Right arm down, left arm tall. So you feel good to brush your left arm alongside your ear. Breathe into the intercostals. Lightly press your left hip bone forward and squeeze your right glute to tuck it under. We extend the left arm, inhale. Exhale, left arm down. Habarita Trikonasana. So left foot crawls in into the left. Left hand can always come to a book or something if the earth is too far away. Pull your right hip back, reach the right arm tall. Just like revolve top moon, but it's landed. Relax your neck. You might need to look at your left hand. One more inhale. Exhale, gaze down, right arm down. We're coming into a runner's lunge. Left knee down, straighten your right leg. Walk your hands forward as full. Stay as you did in your warm-up or full split. Slide your right heel forward. You don't need to be all the way down to try it. If you want to today, think of squaring your hips and chest. So left hip bone forward, back, right hip bone back, left hip bone forward. Inhale and exhale, fold over the leg. Thank you. Good. Another inhale. Exhale. Draw your muscles up and in or shift forward to meet in a runner's lunge. And then step that right foot back, down dog. Sway it out a little. Breathe. High plank, top of the push-up, inhale. Chaturanga Dandasana, exhale. Urdhva Mukha, lift, showcase your heart. Breathe here. Thighs up, chest forward. Energy rising, this positive effect spreading and emanating. One more inhale. Exhale, down dog, lift it up. Walk your hands towards your feet, back of your mat. Find Malasana, heels in, toes out. Take a little squat. Hands can come to heart, chin to chest. Option stay, a right shoulder tucks to inner thigh, left arm tall. Open up here. Stay here, bind, right hand threads around. Search for your left fingertips, open up left chest. You can stay or start to stand, weight into the left foot. You can slide that right foot in. It's kind of like bird of paradise. You just have a bent right knee. You might tip your chest forward. When I do that, my right hip always pops. In a good way. Good, if you came up, think up to slowly come back down. Open up your knees if you are bound. Give it another inhale. Exhale, standing forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Two more with breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Walk it out, my friends. Downward facing dog. You can take a vinyasa, you could take a handstand, you can take child's pose. You have a breath, so I'm going to walk you through a little handstand. So you walk your feet in until your shoulders come over your wrists. Send one leg back. The moment the down foot leaves the ground, think of hugging that thigh into that side of your rib cage. So bend the knee, hop, thigh in the rib. Hop, thigh in the rib. Keep doing that a few times. You're gonna find a catch point where your hips step over your shoulder and the forward leg is gonna almost work as a lever. So one knee is bent and one leg is straight. So it's almost like you're teeter-tottering your weight. Then you could start to straighten the leg out. I say it like it's easy. I'm well aware that it's not, but it's just a little different variation. So the moment the down foot leaves the ground, thigh and the rib. When you're done, down dog, let it go. Deep breath in. Let go. You take an intermission of core. So lift your heels, bend your knees, step or jump through. Come onto your back. Happy baby. Bend your knees, reach up for your arches, rock it out a little, side to side. Just got these pants and they weren't very expensive, so there's a chance that they're see-through. And if so, I should have had you guys sign some kind of consent form or something by that. I'm just kidding. I forget that some people watching this might not know me. They just stumbled upon it on the internet and they think I'm a total creep. Oh, here's the small world. Oh, we can't do Korda. It's a small world. All right, come on, rock back and up. Take a vinyasa, rinse it out. We'll meet in down dog. Take your time. Good. When you're ready, lift your heels, bend your knees, come forward, top of the mat. Big toes touch, inhale level. Exhale, fold. Find chair pose with me, Uttanasana. Inhale. Exhale, hands to your heart, Pavarita Uttanasana. Inhale. Exhale, twist right elbow outside the left knee, knees touch. Maybe right arm down, left arm high. Stay or cycle, you can crouch down. Hands are about shoulder width. You're gonna layer your thighs, layer your knees to pick your feet up. You can kick your heels out or split your legs. For whatever you chose, give it another breath. Knee back and revolve chair. Another inhale. Exhale, forward bend, let it go. Inhale, flat back. Step, jump, or float. Move through your vinyasa. Bring knee together, down dog. Reset. Come back to this here now space. This is it. When you're ready, big toes together, left leg lifts, let the knee bend and the hip open. Enjoy yourself here. If you'd like to flip your dog, shift forward. While the left foot lands wide to the side, roll your iliac cuffs up, roll the ribs up. The left fingertips play. You might be able to straighten your right leg. If this were a word, it would be my favorite word in the human language, this feeling. Another inhale. Exhale, spin around. Left hand under left shoulder, left leg lifts. Inhale. Exhale, left knee, right shoulder. Thread it through its ball of triangle. Left leg slides out. Left heel spins in. Right heel forward, lie back. Breathe. Roll those hips up. Try to ground your feet. Use the earth as leverage to rise. Ground what's rooted, lift what's not. There's so much that we share. It's time we're aware. It's a small. Good, another. Inhale. Exhale, right hand under right shoulder. Left leg lifts, dog split. Inhale. Exhale, left knee, left shoulder. We're making that box. Left wrist, right shoulder. Left shoulder, left wrist, right shoulder. One more. To the left, low, to the right. High, take it left, sweep it out tall. Stretch it out. Big inhale. Exhale, left foot lands between your hands. Straighten both legs, walk to your right. Toes angled in. You could fit one leg between your two feet. Left fingertips forward. Thread your right arm through. Grab your left shin. Twist. Eyes can close. Make sure you're not heel heavy. Breathe. Good. Inhale. Exhale, unwind. Hand wraps around your left leg. Bring your nose towards your knee or your shin. Fold in. You can do no wrong. Just hug, feel, breathe. One more inhale. Exhale, pivot forward, runner's lunge. Step your right foot forward to meet your left. Plant your hands, come high on the balls of the feet, find your crow. Bend your elbows, you don't have to take flight to do this, just press your knees higher than your elbows. Tip the weight into the hands. Stay right here with us. Good, it's half moon, left toes behind the left wrist. Feel that right hip and right chest open. Illuminate through your fingers and through your toes. Even feel a stretch in the webbing. Notice when you fall, that's when the mind wanders away from the present. Reel it back. We're stable. Good. When you're ready, bend your right knee. Right hand reaches back to the little edge of your foot. Angel wings clip together. Expose the heart. Chakrasana. Arch and Drasana, spread out, big inhale. Exhale to revolve, right fingertips down. You want to roll that right hip bone down. So there's a long line from the crown of the head back through your right heel. Then reach your left arm high. Feel the twist is coming from your belly button more than your shoulders. Notice that right leg might want to droop, energize it. Stay here, bend your right knee, left hand grabs the top of the foot, lift the thigh, try to square your shoulders forward. Three. Good, inhale. Exhale, revolve, half moon. One more inhale. Exhale, left hand down, it's needle posture. If you wanna do pickups, you can. If you wanna work on balance, you can wrap your hands around your ankle. Let that right glute feel active in this posture. That's gonna hoist the leg up higher. For whatever you chose to do, give it another inhale. Exhale, runner's lunge. Plant your hands, kick that left leg tall. Inhale. Exhale, left foot lands between your hands. Virabhadrasana 1. So we're strong without being forceful. It's more intention driven than force. Good, inhale. Exhale, Virabhadrasana 2, soft eyes over left middle finger. Your wrists are currently floating over your ankles. Inhale. Exhale, peaceful, right hand down, right shin. Left arm back, breathe into left side body. Inhale. Exhale, Uttita Parsva Uttanasana. Left hand inside, arch of foot, right arm alongside the ear. And you'll recall that we stay for a while, so if you want to work on a bind, you can. Left hand through the gap of the leg, searching for right fingers. If you want to work on the bird of paradise, you can follow me. We're going to start to step this right foot forward. Transfer the weight onto the right foot as we start to stand up. Once you come out, so if you want, you can start to straighten your left leg, maybe even look towards the heavens. If you chose to come up, slowly reverse the steps to come out. We're going to meet in side angle. Our friends who have been there all along are champions. That was hard. Inhale. Exhale to get back. Peaceful warrior. Big breath. Out breath, straighten your left leg. Reach. Inhale. Exhale, Trikonasana. We have time. Legs are strong. Ribbons of muscle in the waist are long. And stay as you're soaring through the sky. Or maybe right arm alongside the right ear. Breathe into that ribbon of muscle through right side body. Make sure your neck is comfortable. Breathe into this moment like it's all that matters. One more inhale. Exhale, right hand down. Shorten and stagger your stance. Pavarita Trikonasana. Right hand on either side of that left foot, maybe to a book or two if you need to bring the earth up. We can be resourceful. Left arm tall. Make sure your neck is comfortable. If your front left knee is currently bent, you might want to step your right foot in more. One more inhale. Exhale, gaze down, left arm down. We meet our runner's lunge. Revisit that half split. So your right hand to your right hip, left leg long like your warm up. Walking the fingers out, inhale and folding in, exhale. Or sliding your left heel forward towards full Hanumanasana. If you have those books, you can always place your hands on the book. keep the pelvis lifted, but try to square it. If you're all the way down, you can start to fold. We have a moment. Maybe close the eyes. Good. When you're ready, shift into a runner's lunge. Take your time. And then send that left leg back down low. Stretch it out. Lift your heels up tall and bend your knees. Press your chest into your ribs. Or ribs into your thighs, rather. And go ahead and straighten those legs on your exhale. Walk your hands to your feet. Heels in and toes out, finding malasana, hands to your beautiful heart. Slight tuck of the chin to the chest. If you want to go deeper, leave this left shoulder, tuck it into the thigh. Left fingertips walk to the left and then a little to the wall behind you. You'll feel that. Right arm high. Option to stay or thread your left hand towards the lower back, reaching for your right fingers or wrists. If you want standing down malasana, you switch your right toes forward. Transfer the weight into your right foot as you come to stand. It's going to feel a lot like a bird of paradise. You might even tip your chest forward like your chest is level with the mat. And then lift it back up. If you chose to do that, think up. Let's slowly come down. We coalesce from these wide open wings, big inhale. Exhale, hands to heart, malasana, give it another breath. And fingers down, straighten your legs, uttanasana. Inhale, level, and exhale, fold. Walk it out, completely skip down dog, walk it all the way forward into your plank. We're going to hold here for 5 compassionate breaths. So the compassion comes with our thoughts we have towards ourselves, the thought we have towards something that's challenging, maybe something we didn't choose. Compassionate towards the idea that maybe it's exactly what we need, what's meant for us. That this moment is a lot better than we might think in a negative state of mind. Compassion towards opportunity, towards optimism. It's just what you wanted to hear while you're in plank, right? One more inhale.
It distracted you, if nonetheless.
Exhale, lower down. Set up for 3 big cobras, legs long, inhale. Exhale, roll the shoulders, slide them back and down, open your heart, inhale. Exhale, down. 2 more, inhale. Exhale, roll the shoulders, lift your heart, open freely. Exhale, down. 1 more, inhale. Exhale, roll the shoulders, reveal your heart, take a big loving breath. Tuck your toes, lift your hips, stand up. Deep breath in. Sigh. Okay, this time we are going to do core, so lift your heels, bend your knees, step or jump through, come onto your back, just hug your knees into your chest for a moment. Rock a little side to side. Nice job. Take your legs straight up. Slip your hands under your sacrum. Slowly take your legs down together for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're just a few inches over your mat. Sweep both feet to the right and then to the left. Just keep sweeping horizontally, side to side. You're going to feel your core muscles are super active right now. And there's a little perk. You can probably feel the massage from your knuckles and the bones of your wrists into your glutes. Free massage for 10, 9, keep going. You can rest and come back, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, keep sweeping, you've got this, 3, 2, 1, legs together, flex your feet, take it back, 3, 2, 1, good, point your toes, keep your legs together, bring both feet towards the top left-hand corner of your mat. And as slowly as you can, horseshoe up, sweep them over to the right top hand corner. And flow like that, up and down. You might be tempted to go faster, to rush it. Let's do the opposite, let's slow it down. I'm so sensitive to the moment that you're experiencing things that otherwise might fly under the radar. You're noticing your glutes on the backs of your wrists. You're noticing your shoulder blades melting down. You're noticing where there's heat, maybe in your belly. We're here just a little while longer. This is a moving meditation. One more big horseshoe. Take your legs all the way up. This is it for core. Bring your legs down 50% and hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 75%. Hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it down 90%. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Flex your feet, bring both legs up. 3, 2, 1. Liberate your hands. Happy baby. Enjoy. Feel free to rock it out side to side. Rise up for back bending, and then we'll come right back here. So when you're ready, rock back and up. Take a vinyasa. If you don't want a vinyasa, that's no worries. Just step back to down dog. If you are doing the vinyasa, let yourself feel liquid from that fluid state. We're all in down dog together. We take a large inhale and a full exhale. Ustrasana, knees find the mat and curl your toes. Take your time to roll back. Massage those shoulders. Hands to lower back, relax your glutes. Roll the shoulders, push through the femurs forward, travel back and breathe. Relax your throat. That ubiquitous goodness from all around you flood into your heart, fill your body up. Inhale. Exhale, hands up your hips, child's pose. Toes together, knees apart, surrender. Close your eyes and breath. Come back to this space, breathe. Down dog. And just flip that camel pose onto our tummies for Dandasana. Roll forward to plank. Take five counts to lower down. Five. Four. You've got it. Three. Two. One. Good. Bend your knees. Reach back for your ankles or tops of your feet. Snuggle your knees close. Inhale. Exhale. Left. Breathe. Let your head right back. Keep breathing. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Legs long. Hands down. Press your palms. Inhale. So roll the shoulders, lift your heart. Down dog. Breathe here. It's your final down dog. Enjoy it. So nice. When you're ready, slide your knees towards your wrists. Come onto your back, knees in the chest. Final heart opener, half bridge or first wheel, or full wheel, feet hip width, ground your feet, inhale, exhale, lift your hips, stay here or hands frame your ears, first coming onto the crown of the head and then all the way up, third Urdhva Dvajrasana. Close your eyes, do what feels good to you, you have a full 8 breaths. If you need more time, continue to explore. If you're ready, come back down. Happy baby. Just breathe. Seal with a little twist as the knees come in. Cross your right thigh over the left. You can hook at your ankles. Hips scooch a little to the right. Knees fall to the left. Arms up. And put your left hand on your right thigh. Right cheek to the mat. Relax. Change out your left, so left knee and thigh over the right, and hook at your ankles too. Scoot your hips to the left, knees drop right, right hand can rest on your left thigh, left arm out, left shoulder down. Maybe left cheek towards the mat. Another breath. When you're ready, come back to center. You have a minute to do what feels good to you. If you need a plow pose, if you need another happy baby or shoulder stand, or maybe just a hug. Continue to enjoy this moment in your own company. When you feel ready, slip into your Shavasana. You need a blanket. You need something to cover your eyes. Get that for yourself. So once you lie down, your body is so comfortable, it will not be a distraction. It will be your biggest supporter. As your body gets comfortable and you feel held by the earth, do a little meditation that's inspired by Katie Byron, The Work. The meditation is simply 4 contemplative questions. A way to tap into your own insight, your own inner wisdom. So what I'd invite you to do now is to think of a thought or a belief system that is troubling you. One thought or one belief that by believing it right now, it's causing you distress. Get that in your mind. Now we're just going to explore it. Is this thought true? Is this thought without a doubt, with 100% certainty, definitely true? And how do I respond? How do I react when I believe this thought? And who would I be if I chose not to believe it? Allow yourself to rest here, be in this state for as long as you'd like. If you're ready to come up, take your time to reawaken. You might curl into fetal pose for a little while, relax. Or whatever you choose to do, imagine this little thin blanket of peace and well-being has been laid over you, wrapped around you. You're cocooned in peace and well-being. If you're ready to come up, we'll meet in Sukhasana, a nice easy seat together. Wherever you are, you can bring your hands to your heart to connect. Thank you so much for sharing your energy, your practice with me, with one another. We're all connected. The light in me sees, loves, honors, and supports the light in you. Namaste.